Hello, sweet internet. I'm Gav.
I'm Dan.
That's DJ Dan. We're the Slow Mo Guys. A while ago, we did a video where we spun a CD so fast, it shook itself to pieces. It sort of warbled and then flung out.
Warbled?
Yeah.
Right, okay. Well, this time, we've got some records. We're kicking it old school.
Yeah. I feel bad breaking these, to be honest. Yeah. It's almost like ripping a book. It's just not to be done, is it?
I know what you mean, but I did get them from Goodwill.
Yeah.
So I feel like people are done with them, they've experienced it, now we're going to put them to a second use in a second life. So
immortalized forever on the internet.
So this is the loading procedure. If you didn't see the previous video, then I'll explain this something. This is actually the motor from inside of I think it's a Dyson. So it can spin at incredibly high speeds. I think that's probably all right.
God, imagine putting a needle on this, what it would sound like.
It would be... It's already kind of wonky. This record isn't perfectly straight. You know when you see them being played on a gramophone, they kind of go like...
Yeah.
Like that. I don't know if this is going to survive long. So because we're just using the motor from a Dyson, it's an incredibly fast Hoover motor. That's how it works. It spins really fast. But if you were to just turn it on straight away, it would be spinning at maximum speed. And that's just kind of not what we want. We want to get the gradual build-up and then eventually the breaking of the record. So for that, we're going to use this variac, which means that you put a voltage through it and you can vary the output, increasing it gradually until we hit that exact breaking point we need.
I'm excited.
Yeah, me too.
Slightly scared too.
Yeah, it makes a hell of a noise. It's really intimidating.
Shooting on the V2640, we're going to start at 12,500 frames a second. I think if this works, we'll paint one.
All right.
Paint one with different quadrants so you can see it spin better.
Sounds good to me. This damn vise is going everywhere. This thing is so powerful. It's like shaking the vise everywhere. I need to like tighten it down. God, that goes. That goes. Whoa.
Look at this.
Oh, it's like coloured it. It's turned it into... Oh, jeez. That's crazy.
Where did it go?
Whoa, it just got eviscerated, I think. Oh, look, there's a big chunk of it there. That's a big chunk.
Okay.
Yeah, I was all the way over there, and some tiny little fragments were, like, bounced off of this and went...
Little bits of musical dust.
Yeah, dust. I think that was... You know what? I think that took more than the CD.
Really?
I think so. Look what it's done to the wood here.
Oh.
It's, like, embedded itself in the wood. Fully, almost cracked the wood open.
This is lethal.
I'm actually glad we put these up.
Yeah.
You know?
I was getting worried that we were going to send it across the fences.
Well, if there's pieces like this, then it's possible.
At this speed, it's almost like you could play the music at it.
Yeah, this is the music speed, I think.
Yeah.
This is what is actually...
This is slowed down to be... Oh. Is it warping? Yeah, now it's warping. Yeah, you can see on the reflection that it's going a bit...
It must just happen at a certain speed where it's like, and now I'm warping. It's weird because it... stabilizes it initially. Oh, God.
Wow.
What the? There's like a chunk of it still on there. God.
Okay, let's do that frame by frame.
Okay, so it split from the middle. See that crack starting?
Yeah, I see that.
Worked its way through.
Turned into like a tree either side.
Wow, that's so weird. It looks like lightning going through it.
It pretty much does, and that means that one, like each of those halves, is now like really vulnerable to cracking, and then.
Oh, and the other look on the left, they're just going.
They just turn to glass, like they just turn to dust. It's kind of good that we've got the blocks there because it shatters it after it's gone.
Yeah.
Because there were some big chunks coming out of that.
I think we should move the blocks on the right side, just slightly further away.
Whee!
Oh, it's just chipped the top, edge. Yeah. I think, just for safety, we should build up one higher.
You think so?
Yeah. Like, this is coming off at some ridiculous clip.
What? Some clip.
Because we've got enough light, I'm just going to change the shutter angle to 90 degrees. Each exposure is now 20 microseconds, approximately, which should, well, get rid of half the motion blur.
Oh, I also need a shield. I'll just hide behind that wood thing.
Or the tree?
Too far away.
Too far away?
Yeah, the wires don't reach. Yep. I was like, there's not much more to give on this.
Really?
Yeah, I was nearly full whack there. I mean, nearly full whack.
There's surely no way it's at its full speed with that on it. Like, the motor's only meant to spin a small fan.
But because the record is heavier, it's slowing it down more, so it's not being able to get the same RPM as the CD. Yeah. This one's cracked slightly differently. It's not in such a straight line. It's gone, like, sideways. You can see the marks that it's left on the brick.
Really?
Yeah.
You want to watch this for this? Yeah. Okay, you ready?
Whoa!
Gosh. That one was different because it crept from the outside. See the crack at the bottom now?
Yeah. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 frames and it was gone. That broke really similarly to the CD.
Yeah, that was because it broke from the outside, that was exactly how the CD went. And then it just misted itself. It's like glitter. Look at the sparkle. So let's move everything 6 feet back.
Oh God, it's so much effort to move these kind of blocks. It's ridiculous.
So we thought we'd make it easier to be able to do maths on this. So we painted quadrants. Well, you painted.
I say I painted quadrants. It's not really.
I'd say that blue is questionable. It's got sort of a slightly bigger piece of the pie.
You just complain about everything, don't you? I can't do anything right. You didn't say do like an amazing job of it. It was just like a basic thing. Sorry I didn't measure it out to the millimeter. God.
Shall I preface everything now? Oh, by the way, do an amazing job on it.
Yeah. Otherwise I'll just do a shoddy job, obviously.
No, I like it. I think it's funny.
Okay. It's locked in there.
So let's play a guessing game.
Yeah.
So there's always a piece that goes straight up and that doesn't shatter.
Mm-hmm.
What colour do you think it'll be? I reckon blue.
Ah, yellow.
Yellow?
For sure.
All right. I wonder what colour that'll look like when it's spinning. I mean, if it was red, green and blue, it would appear white. But because of the yellow...
Appear yellow?
Yeah, maybe. Let me just document your shield.
All right. Well, first of all, I've got to be in comfort. So I've got a nice recliner behind here.
Yeah.
So that I can do it in comfort. And second of all...
That's your variac.
I'm hidden behind here with the variac. I'll, like, use my head to... shield myself, turn it on, and then just like. Golly, gosh me. So it ended up breaking at 115 there, but it's only got this much more to give. So it's really at the limits of
it's hungry.
Yeah, it really
hungry
is.
Hungry lad. Yeah, it was another crack from the outside, that one.
Shall I see?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. It looks cool with the colours, doesn't it? It's like a really convoluted way of painting something.
Yeah. Blue went up.
Damn it. Without even seeing the slow-mo, you can tell which colours went where, because if you look, green is all at the bottom there, you follow it round, then it's all the red, then it slowly turns to blue.
Well, that's why the sky is blue.
Yeah. Got people laughed at that.
and then
there's more blue, and then it goes yellow. I think it broke more or less perfectly in quarters. Blue, yellow, green, red.
We're now looking at this edge to see how much it warps. The whole wood top went.
Oh, jeez. Oh, look at that. Look at the damage it's done here.
Oh,
God. That's insane.
That is insane. It looks like scarring.
Look, you can see the individual pieces that have hit it and the fact they've gone more wobbly as it goes along. then come back again. Look, it's gone like, you can see a graph where it's gone wobbly and then not so wobbly. I bet if it carried on, it'd be like this. Like a wave. Like
it's
that.
A way to record onto a physical medium.
Yeah,
it's like look, an instant graph.
It goes like this, like that, and then it comes back around again, and it goes like a wave all the way around. I bet that's exactly what you'll see on the slip-mo.
That is a severe amount of warp.
Wow. I'm surprised it's even managed to stay in focus. It's moving around so much.
It's just appalling, isn't it?
It really is.
Oh, it split from the middle.
Oh, did it?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
How I was many... hoping it would split exactly on the front focus line.
Well, that would be amazing. I wonder what the, like, how much centimetres-wise it was actually varying in Wibbleman.
I don't know. I
guess we'll just do one more.
Ta-da!
What a beaut.
Thank you.
This one is being shot square, so we can stabilize it in post and spin the shot, in theory.
I've also got the wood in the shot, so if we see any of that scarring, we'll be able to see how I did it.
Oh yeah. Powering up engines, starting jet. One came directly at this thing.
Did it?
I heard it audibly, like, go...
And it must have been a rebound. There's no way it would have come straight at you.
No, exactly. It must have, like, rebounded off the stone.
There you go. Oh, from the outside again. From the blue. So let's see which bit came at you. So it came off the corner.
That must have been what hit you.
You think so? It must have, it was coming the same sort of angle.
Look at how fast that's spinning towards her.
Yeah. I almost felt it though. So it must have been a chunky piece.
Did you say my name?
Huh? A chunky piece?
Yeah, it's my nickname. Look at the 3D nature of some of this stuff. It's just absolutely compressed. Get some side on.
It looks like someone's taken like mascara and wiped it on a brick wall. Look, it looks like someone's just gone like, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Found some more.
Do you know what's good about that video?
What's that?
We've shattered all the records.
Is that good?
What do you mean?
Like you're doing a record breaking pun.
Well, yeah.
Yeah. You know what, with your puns, you're like one of these.
Like,
broken record.
There you go.
That was insane. We never had this cage around it last time when it was the CD because it was so light, it just lost all its velocity. Like the drag from all the air just slowed it all down. This stuff, this could have gone miles.
Well, the very fact that this still exists after hitting the cage.
Yeah.
Tells you, like this is super thick as well. Right in the middle, it's the records are thicker than they are on the outside. So the outside bits hit this and turn to dust and these would go flying, but luckily, most of the energy is taken up by hitting this.
Yeah, these parts are bigger, A, because they were in the center and they were released at a slower velocity, and also the label sort of holds it together.
Yeah.
That was crazy. I'm glad it's over because that was kind of scary. I might take a picture of these and post it on Twitter and I'll say, you'll never guess how we painted these bricks.
No one will guess.
I don't think anyone will get it
no
right.
No one. But I don't think a record has ever been used in that way before.
No?
No.
Well, so that was a record breaking.
Yeah, I think it was. I think it was a record breaking squared.
God. Well, that was cool. Hopefully you enjoyed that video. Feel free to subscribe to our very channel right here. We've got a second one as well, behind the scenes. I play pranks on Dan a lot, don't I?
Yeah, you do.
Yeah, I do. And all the social medias and stuff. Thank you very much for watching.
Do you know, in the future,
yeah,
when, like, you know how we have, like, archaeologists that would go to places like Rome and Greece and they'll piece together all the pottery and be like, this was used to store grain. Do you think in the future they'll find these and be like, well, and they'll glue one of these all together.
It
and
appears to have been shattered apart by itself.
Yeah. Yeah.
This is where you grow grain.
That's what they sound like. Or the guy from Time Team who's like, right, this...
the guy that wasn't Tony
this
Robinson.
This part, would, yeah. The one with the long hair.
It was clearly faking a West Country accent.
Yeah, as soon as he got on camera, he was just like, well, you talk like this now. I just talk like this normally.
And then cut. Thank you, Charles. Yeah, yeah, thank you. In my trailer.
Yeah.